Hello everyone. Welcome back to the next session of budgeting, which will include the advantages of budgetary control, essentials for successful budgeting. It forms a part of the fifth semester BSc HNHA. Moving further, we will study about the advantages of budget and budgetary control, characteristics of a good budget, and the duties of a financial controller in this particular session. Moving further, if you want to know what the advantages of budgetary control are as follows. It provides an overall picture, an overall image of the result which is expected from all the departments of the hotel with the proposed plan of action. Also, it serves as a guide or as a way to the various executives who are responsible for the various departments of the hotel. Now, the maximum efficiency is achieved how? By avoiding maximum amount of wastage and the loss of manpower and materials. So we will be able to earn the maximum efficiency. Now, budgetary control also has to ensure coordination and central control within all the departments. It helps to monitor the performance, since if we are not able to achieve the forecasted budgets, we will know what our overall performance of the employees is and of the staff is and how each department is doing in terms of their forecasted budgets. Now, if we compare what our actual performance is with what we had already forecasted, we will be able to calculate the variance. So the actual will be minus from the budgeted ones, or if we are doing well, we will have if we are doing well in terms of the actual performance, our deviation will be towards the right side, right way, and that will be good for the department. A major amount of deviation in between the actual performance and the budget standards is not recommended. Whereas, if there is certain kind of small modifications that are required, those can be done in between. Now, what are the essentials for a successful budgeting? Or we can say, what are the characteristics of a good budget? Now, the budget that has to be created should be well defined and well determined. And the budget period must always be fixed. The key factors or the limiting factors we can say are like availability of equipments. There is no availability of raw materials, the technology, the innovations, skilled workforce. If we do not have, they have, it definitely has to be determined. Also, the ideas and suggestions from all the people of the department who are focusing on the budgets of their department, the feedback and suggestions have to be taken from them. Also, the main responsibility for administrating the budgeting program, it is given to the executive of the finance department, we can also say as a budget controller. Moving further, we should also be knowing the duties of a financial controller. Now, the financial controller definitely has to coordinate and communicate the efforts of each person who is engaged in the preparation and who is analyzing the budgets of their department. They also help in defining a certain budget time, and if required, department people have to be notified on that. They collect data on actual revenues of cost, actual revenues and costs, what we earn and what we have the expenses, and we have to compare both of them to calculate the actual budgeted performance of each department and as well as of the hotel. They also offer feed to various departments concerning significant deviation from their budgets. If any department has a major deviation from the budgeted amounts, the forecasted budgets, those have to be informed to them timely. Well, that's all for now, and in the next session we will be learning about the preparation of budget, types of budget, and types of budget would include fixed and flexible budget, sales budget, operating budgets, financial budget, flexible and fixed budget. Thank you so much. We'll see you soon for the next session.